Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for August the 25th of 2019, well, it is titled Leaving Earth. So what do we see here? Well, this is a video clip that runs just about 12 seconds and shows a number of images combined together to make a little time lapse showing the Earth fading off in the distance as a spacecraft leaves it. And this was the Messenger spacecraft, which was launched from Earth and sent to visit Mercury. Oh, Mercury, one of the least studied of the planets, especially by far the least studied of the inner planets, only having had two visits from spacecraft. Back in the 1970s, we had Mariner 10, which flew by Mercury and gave us our first up-close images of it. And then the Messenger spacecraft, which was there this century and explored Mercury for a number of years before finally running out of fuel and crashing into its surface. So as you play the video, you will see that the Earth starts up very close, and you can see that only a portion of the Earth is illuminated, so the sun off to the distance there, and the Earth shining by reflected sunlight, very, very bright. So why do we not see stars in this image? Well, they are overwhelmed by the brightness of the Earth. So in order for the Earth to be able to be seen, you don't have a long enough exposure to be able to bring out the stars. If you wanted to bring out the stars, you would have to get a much lower exposure of the Earth. And you can see the rotation of the Earth in the time lapse. You can see the cloud cover on the Earth. So we can see our world fading off into the distance as a spacecraft launched from the Earth heads off into space to explore another planet. And of course, it is interesting to see the Earth as a phase. We're used to looking at things that the only thing we're used to seeing with phases is our moon. But phases, seeing things as a crescent phase as we're seeing here, can occur any place. Any object that shines by reflected light, which would be everything in the solar system except for our sun, would be able to exhibit phases if you were looking at it from the right perspective. So if you're looking from the moon, you would watch the Earth go through phases, just as we on the Earth watch the moon go through phases. Through a telescope, you can actually see planets go through phases. From the Earth, Mercury and Venus will go through phases being closer to the sun. If you were further out in the solar system, you would be able to see other planets go through phases as well. So it's really just a matter of how the sunlight is reflecting off of it. So essentially the sunlight illuminates half of an object, and we can see half of an object, and how those overlap, the part that is being illuminated and that we can see, gives us the phase. So if a small portion of the illuminated side is visible, we'll see things like a crescent phase. If a large portion is seen, we will see something closer to a full phase. So you can see part of that here in a specific phase as Messenger was moving away from the Earth, and the Earth fades and gets smaller and smaller as Messenger heads away off into the distance. So that was our picture of the day for August the 25th of 2019. It was titled Leaving Earth. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be painting or photograph. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.